continued. The vicious assault of Pavi by Terrence and Phillip. I believe it or not, on paper, the Largos are winning, kind of. Even though, yeah, Pavi's getting his ass handed to him. Then Pavi fights back a little bit. Just a little. Not a whole lot. By the way, hang on a moment. Just got a note. In spite of all this, in spite of the advantage, Terrence and Phillip have been banned from farting in this match. I'm wondering why. Jeez, that's like not letting Anne Frank have a drum. Oh, that's awful. But, you know, I say that because I'm out here and Pavi's trapped inside the cage. Why I think it's awful. What's a cage up there? Imagine if it was a glass cage. He'd be screwed. What? Knee drop! And it looks like advantage Team Terrence and Phillip. Pavi meets Steel. Steel meet Pavi. Knee drop! And there's Terrence and Luigi outside. It's down to two men. Pavi and Phillip. And that has a nice little ring to it. And Pavi does a ring. Does that neckbreaker thingy. That's freaking fur, you freak! Oh, that's not right. Doesn't Reagan have a sexual harassment policy going on? I mean, there should be. For those of you who remember Cockade, Pavi was, violated a lot. Several times over. Yeah, but he had to use his own product to recreate. I won't go there. It's wrong. It's wrong. And as I'm talking about what's horribly wrong, here's something that's right. It looks like Terrence and Phillip have won this match. Phillip is getting closer, 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 and Terrence and Phillip win. I wonder if they'll gloat about this at all. Luigi's not happy. He's bitching his brother out. He doesn't care if Frank taught him. He didn't like Frank needed that advantage. Terrence and Phillip are having too much fun with this. They didn't even have to fart. They didn't even get a chance to fart in his face. They just... Terrence and Phillip are your winners. Oh, Ruby Rod is... Oh, Superman Prime is facing the tag team debut of Dr.Rockso and his best friend Mr. Rogers, since he's adapted that creepy clown thing that he does. Well, it could be his plus sign star, Extreme Rules. Extreme Rules, it is the NCA Coast to Coast Championship. William Wallace is defending against Cockknocker. Cockknocker won the right to challenge William Wallace for the Coast to Coast Championship last week. And William Wallace has proven to be quite the formidable champion. He's only been pinned once his entire NCAA career. That was against Superman Prime, and Superman's an asshole. He's a tough asshole, but seems to me like they need to get Cock Doctor. I wonder if he's gonna. I'll punch you in the jeans. I'll punch you in the jeans. This is not a jeans. A man versus machine. You the deck. Thought you got away clean. I'll roll up on you smooth and punch you in the jeans. I don't like Cock Doctor, but and I think his move should be banned, but hands down, I gotta say, Cock Knocker possesses the most devastating finishing move in all of Kaw. That's right, all of Kaw. And that's why it should be illegal. Dylan wants to be punched in the dick. Punched in the dick. Punched in the dick. Oh, that intercontinental something or other. And that's what it's all about! The NCAA Coast to Coast Championship. Keep in mind this. William Wallace had that tough... They're having words. It's Extreme Rules. Cock Knocker being wise and scored, and William Wallace gets the chair away from Cock Knocker. William Wallace had a very, very super tough title defense at Revelations. This is his first match since then. It was a I Quit match. Submission match. I quit. I don't care. Takes a little bit of your ego. Takes a little bit of your pride. Takes years off your career. That was the passion of Wallace, if I ever saw it. Scottish Slam! On the floor. Scottish Destroyer! This is the beginning of the end already, I think. I was surprised he didn't. I'm surprised Cock Knocker is still moving after this. And Cock Knocker took the Coast to Coast Championship. It's his right to do so. I don't know what he was trying to prove there. And William Wallace is just disorientated. He had his bell ring. This is not falls count anywhere. This is one fall in the ring to a finish. No one's going to lose by DQ no matter what they do. And Wallace still feeling the effects of that match, Revelations. Say what you want. Even though Cock Knocker has the advantage right now, and I don't like what this is gonna turn out to be. And the dick! And the dick! And the dick again! And the dick again! And the dick again! And the dick again! Thank you for holding up that sign! Ow! It hurts just to watch! And punch. Oh. Ow. It's like Serpent in the Rainbow. Thank you, guy who held up the sign. It hurts to watch that move. In spite of everything, how William Wallace is even standing at this point is beyond me. That's dramatic pause. back suplex through the table. Who are those guys saying my table? Both these men. This match hasn't even been, you know, like this 45-minute marathon, but I'm worn out just by watching it. And this is what I think it is. Let's go out on the top rope. Advantage cock knocker. William Wallace slowly meandering up. And splash, Sting style. Another splash, Sting style. And William Wallace has got the 2x4. A little disoriented, they both are. They've taken some pretty vicious moves there. And, oh, don't do this! Don't do this! I don't like Cock Knocker, but don't put your career at risk. Oh. That can put Quick into his career. Scottish Destroyer! And William Wallace is going to pay Cock Knocker back for all those punches in the dick. With wood. That didn't sound right. Any way you spin it. Cock Knocker's got the table. He stole William Wallace's wood. Advantage Cock Knocker. Now, Cock Knocker has had a good showing against Kate Skywalker, and he's proving he is championship caliber. Don't do it. Don't do it. Just barely missing the table. That would have been a sweet spot, I do have to say. And William Wallace is barely standing. Cock. And the tables are flaming. And to be continued after this.